Ricky, you've been around boxing how many years?
Ooh, 22 years.
22 years. And what kind of stars have you been around all these years?
Many.
Like James Toney?
Second to none. Diego Rafael Corrales.
Diego Corrales. What's your favorite moment with Corrales in life, away from boxing?
Just hanging out with each other, you know, having fun, going out to eat.
Was he a comedian? Was he serious?
No, he was a comedian.
Give me an example, some joke.
He would call me and he says, "Hey, I want you to wear your stilettos today." It was hilarious, you know? Wear your red high heels with red pom-poms, you know?
And did you?
Huh? Yeah, it was just hilarious, man. You know, I miss him. I miss him a lot. Because outside of the business, he was a good guy.
You were in the corner when Joe Goosen was there, when you guys fought Castillo.
Our last fight was with him was when we fought Casamayor the third time.
You showed me. You had the corner jacket. It was camouflage. Like you were going like a bandito.
Yeah, that was our last fight that we worked together. And after that, he passed away.
Unfortunately, a very young age. But one thing that's going on today in the world of boxing, everybody's talking about it. Margarito, earlier today, had his eye checked out by top-ranked doctors. Later in the day, he had his eye checked out by the commission doctors. Tomorrow, 3 p.m. Eastern, the commission in New York will decide if he's clear to fight Margarito in New York or if the fight will have to go somewhere else. What do you think about the whole situation with his eye and all that?
Well, I don't know. I mean, they okayed it, but, you know, that's not right. I mean, I would like to see that fight, you know, so he could get that doubt, you know, of the wraps.
Who are you going for that
one? I'm going for Margarito.
Why?
You know, just, I think he got Cotto's number. It's going to be a tough fight, you know. I don't think Cotto, I think he's prepared himself really good for this fight. But you know what? I think the upper hand is going to be Margarito.
Cotto is 100% convinced. He says that he has the evidence that Margarito was loaded when they fought. My take is, I don't have clear-cut evidence. He wasn't caught for that fight. And Margarito, as you know, hits very hard. Because anyone that you talk to that ever sparred him,
It hits hard. I have Caraz, you know, Jesus.
They're now together in Mexico.
They're in Mexico
right
now.
What does Soto tell you about camp?
I haven't spoken to him since he's been up there in camp. But when they used to spar together back in the days, he says that he hits hard. You know, he's like a mule.
What kind of mule?
The mule that's going to kick you.
Because Soto's a character as well.
Oh, he's hilarious. He's like Brandon Rios, you know, my boy Brandon. He's hilarious.
And what do you think? So you think Margarito will be okay, or do you think there'll be a stumble back? What's your...
You know what? New York, it looks like they're becoming very strict, but I think they might have it somewhere else, you know?
They said possibly Denver, Mississippi, or Phoenix. Where would you go?
I heard Texas also.
Maybe.
But we'll see.
Why not Vegas?
Yeah, why not? I don't think they will license them there either because of the hand wraps.
Oh, okay. But that was in L.A.
That was in L.A.
But you're right. He did fight in Texas afterwards. He didn't fight in Vegas or L.A. So anything you would say to Margarito if he's watching?
Yeah, man, just...
In Spanish?
Yeah. Margarito, pon tu cabeza para arriba. Keep focused. Enfoca. Don't let nothing distract you.
He's already flying back to Mexico as we're speaking.
Yeah, you know, he's a good guy. I like him.
Hilarious.
Yeah.
And what do you think about Cotto, about his preparation?
You know what, I can't take nothing of him. He's a warrior also, you know. Every fighter is a warrior, you know. Us as fans outside, you know, we try to dictate who's going to take him. Sometimes we're wrong. But, you know, they're all warriors. Every fighter is a warrior, you know.
There you have it. Stay tuned. Everyone's a warrior except whoever's not.
Right.
For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ali Sekbak reporting. Hey, Ricky, some fighters are just better than others.
Yeah.
Some fighters disappoint you by the way they fight, and some step up to the plate.
Exactly. What do you think about that little world champ, future champ right there?
Man, next year when he turns pro, he's going to make a lot of waves. He hits hard, huh?
Yeah.
Is he like a foot taller than everybody else in his weight class?
Yeah. He fights normally at 119. Right now he's at 125. You know, he's maturing. He just turned 18.
He's what, 6 feet, 6'1"?
No, he's 5'9 right now. He's 5'9, but he's developing into that man, you know, becoming a man.